So today we will be discussing the last configuration of a BJT amplifier. So in the last two classes, we have already discussed about the common emitter and common collector configuration. So one configuration is left, and that is the common base configuration. So for common base configuration, the input signal is applied between the emitter and the base terminal, and the output signal is available between the collector and the base terminal. So therefore, for common base, the base terminal is common to both the input as well as to the output terminals. And so let us first try to understand how does this particular common base circuit will look like. And then obviously, we will be developing the small signal equivalent model of the common base amplifier. And accordingly, we will be finding out the expression for the voltage gain and as well as the expression for the current gain. So to start with, we have a common base kind of configuration. So let us draw the circuit like this. So we have drawn an NPN transistor. So this is the base terminal, this is the emitter terminal. So emitter is considered to be the input terminal over here. So we are making the proper biasing arrangement over here. I would explain why this type of biasing. We have a base resistance to provide the corresponding base emitter junction in the forward bias. And since the base terminal is considered to be AC ground, so this capacitor is connected in shunt in order to make this base terminal AC ground. So suppose this resistance is RE connected to the emitter terminal. This voltage source is VEE, for example. With this terminal negative, this terminal positive. This is the base resistance RB. We have a capacitor CB over here. Now, if I just observe this base emitter junction or this input junction over here, you will find that since we are considering an NPN kind of transistor, so emitter terminal is of N type, base terminal is of P type, and the collector terminal is of N type. Now, as you know, in order to operate the transistor as an amplifier, we have to make this base emitter junction forward bias and the collector base junction in the reverse bias mode. Now, to make this base emitter junction in the forward bias and emitter, since it's an N type of element, so the potential at this emitter should be less as compared to the potential at the base, so that this base emitter junction, this PN junction, is forward biased. So therefore, we have this negative terminal of the battery is connected to the emitter terminal through a resistance RE, and we have the base resistance RB over here, which will act during the DC analysis. However, for the AC analysis, this base resistance will not be there because we have a capacitor in shunt with this base resistance. And during the AC analysis or small signal analysis, the reactance provided by the capacitance will be small enough so that this base terminal will be essentially at AC ground. Now, let us draw the output side. In the output side, we have, this is the collector terminal. So you must have an output resistance RC. And apart from that, we need to connect the supply over here. Now for the output circuit, as you know, this collector base junction must be reverse biased. So therefore, and since this is N type, this collector is of N type and the base is of P type, so this should be the polarity of the DC supply. So this is VCC with this terminal positive, this terminal negative. So this is all about the structure of this common base amplifier. Now we are supposed to get the output from the collector end from here, and where to apply the input. So we are applying the input at between the emitter and the base. we are supposed to apply the input between the emitter and the base, and base is considered to be the common terminal over here. So this is the supply, small signal Vs, which we want to amplify through this common base configuration. Let us consider there is a source resistance associated with it, and we have a coupling capacitor in series with the signal source. This is RS. So we are measuring the output voltage with respect to the collector to the base terminal, and base is essentially at AC ground during the small signal analysis. So this is all about the circuit diagram of a common base amplifier. We have to identify that the base terminal is common to both the input and the output. So input is applied between the emitter to base, and the output is available between the collector to the base. Now, first of all, to identify the gain parameter of this particular amplifier, we need to draw the small signal equivalent circuit. So in the small signal circuit, as you know, between the for this BJT, for this bipolar junction transistor, we have this we can consider this pi model for our analysis. So in pi model, we can have three elements. One is the input resistance R pi connected between the base and emitter. We can have a current source GM times V pi connected between the collector to the emitter terminal. And sometimes we can also connect this R naught output resistance between the collector to the emitter. But in most of the cases, the value of the R naught is considered to be very large. So we can sometimes we can neglect the effect of this R naught, because since it is very large, practically it is in the order of few hundreds of kilo ohms or even higher. So for practical calculation, we can sometimes just neglect the appearance of this R naught. And apart from that, we can also connect those resistances RE, RB, and RC. Now let us take a look whether we can connect all these three resistances in the small signal equivalent circuit. So obviously, for this emitter resistance RE, one terminal is connected to the emitter side, fine. The other terminal of the resistance is connected to VEE, which is a constant supply, which is a constant DC supply. So in the small signal equivalent circuit, this particular point will be at AC ground. So for RE, one terminal is at the emitter terminal, one terminal is connected to the emitter terminal, and the other end is connected to the AC ground. Similarly for RC, this collector resistance, one terminal is connected to the collector and the other terminal is connected to VCC. So this VCC is a constant supply. So for AC analysis, this particular point will be at AC ground. So for RC, one end is connected to the collector terminal and the other end is connected to the ground. Now what about this RB? Now for RB, you find in the small signal equivalent circuit, this particular capacitor, this CB, will provide a very small reactance so that the small signal current will flow through it. And as a matter of fact, this base is at AC ground. So eventually the effect of RB will not be there in the small signal equivalent circuit, because both the two ends of this resistance is connected to the ground terminal. So in the small signal equivalent circuit, we have this RE and RC only. RB will not be there. And I am assuming that the capacitance, the reactance provided by the capacitance is very small. So the effect of the capacitance will not be there in the small signal equivalent circuit as long as we are in the midband region of our operation. So you will understand what is meant by the midband region while we will be considering the frequency response of any amplifier. And secondly, we have the another resistance RS, which should be there in the small signal equivalent circuit, which is connected between the amplifier and the signal source. And we have this coupling capacitor connected between this VS and this amplifier. And assuming that the reactance provided by the capacitance is very small at the signal frequency, so I can consider this coupling capacitor essentially short-circuited. Now, let us draw the small signal equivalent circuit. How does it look like? So to start with, we can have R pi. You can start with R pi between the emitter and the base terminal. Now, as you know, between the collector to emitter, there is a current source. There is a current source. collector to emitter, whose magnitude is given by Gm times V pi. Now, what is that V pi? V pi, as you know, V pi is nothing but the small signal voltage between the base terminal and the emitter terminal. Now, while writing V pi, so this is nothing but equal to Vb minus Ve. So, while writing V pi, so this is nothing but the voltage drop across this R pi, just like this. So, potential at the base terminal with respect to the emitter terminal. So, that was all about this V pi, and accordingly, we can write this Gm V pi, which is nothing but the current source over here. So, this is the collector terminal. So, this completes the equivalent circuit for the BJT itself. Now, we have to connect the externally connected resistances. So, first one is the resistance RD. So, RD is connected between the collector, between the emitter terminal and the ground. So, what we can do is, let me just change this one. No. Okay. Let it be. So this is V pi. So RE is connected between the emitter terminal and the ground. Now base is at AC ground during the small signal analysis. That is fine. Now we have to connect RC, which is nothing but the resistance, output resistance connected between the collector terminal and the output terminal. So this is, from this point, we are supposed to get V naught. And additionally, we need to connect the signal source, which we want to magnify through this amplifier. So this is RS. This is VS, signal source. So this is the base terminal. This is the base terminal, which is essentially at AC ground during the small signal analysis. So this is the equivalent circuit for the common base amplifier, and we are interested in finding out the voltage gain of this small signal amplifier, common base amplifier, which is given by the ratio between V naught upon Vs. So first of all, you have to identify the current that is flowing through this output resistance RC. So the current over here is Gm V pi. Now the direction of the current is from this terminal. So from collect, if I just consider this collector end, the current is flowing from this point to this, from this, from base to collector, like this. So as a matter of fact, I can write the expression for V naught is equal to, what was the current? If I just follow the notation or the direction of the current, it will be like minus Gm times V pi multiplied with RC. So this is the output voltage over here. Now, what about the V pi? So V pi is nothing but the voltage difference between this base terminal and the emitter terminal. That means the voltage across is R pi. Now, at the emitter terminal, if I apply the corresponding KCL equation, then what we are getting over here? So here we have different components of current. So accordingly, we have to find out the current which are entering and the current which are leaving. Now, assuming that this terminal V pi is nothing but the voltage drop between base to emitter. So as far as our notation is concerned, the current will flow from this point to that point, from this point. So the current will flow. So we have a V pi voltage drop over here. So this is at a higher potential with respect to this point, as far as our notation is concerned. So current will flow from this end to that end. Similarly, the same same voltage drop over here, it will be V pi once again. So the current will flow from this end to that end because it is at a higher potential as compared to this point. Now here we have minus V pi potential at this particular point because the voltage drop is V pi and this is kept at zero potential. So obviously, so potential at this point at the emitter terminal will be minus V pi. So already we have Vs over here. So Vs minus or minus V pi. This is the available voltage across this RS. So accordingly, the current which will flow through RS is Vs minus or minus V pi by RS. So these are the total currents, and we have to add this Gm V pi component. So total current entering this emitter terminal must be equal to zero. So accordingly, we can write. So let me write down the different components of the current. So one was Vs minus or minus V pi upon Rs. Vs, so this potential is Vs. Now here, this potential with respect to base, this potential is at minus V pi, because the difference must be V pi. So since it is at minus V pi, so Vs minus or minus V pi divided by Rs is the current flowing through this, plus through the resistance Re, what is the current? The current that is flowing is V pi upon Re through R pi. This is V pi upon R pi. And this current is also entering the emitter terminal, Gm V pi, as far as the notation is concerned. So plus Gm times V pi is equal to zero. So this is the current KCL equation at the emitter node. So if I just simplify, it will be like Vs by Rs is equal to minus V pi by Rs plus V pi by Re plus V pi by R pi plus Gm V pi. Let me go to the next slide. So what you have got? We've got like Vs upon Rs is equal to minus V pi by Rs. Let me once again write that equation. Divided by V pi upon Re plus V pi by R pi plus Gm times V pi. So now this is minus V pi by Rs plus V pi by Re. Now V pi by R pi plus Gm V pi. So if I take V pi common, it will be something like this. V pi into 1 plus, sorry, V pi into one by R pi plus Gm. Now Gm plus 1 by R pi. What is that expression? Already we know this is nothing but R pi over here, 1 plus Gm R pi. So what is Gm R pi? This is nothing but beta, the current gain. So 1 plus beta by R pi. So this is equal to, if I take minus E pi common outside, it will be like 1 upon Rs plus 1 upon Re plus 1 plus beta times R pi, 1 plus beta by R pi. So Vs by Rs is equal to minus V pi multiplied with 1 upon Rs plus 1 upon Re plus 1 plus beta by R pi. So we have three resistances, Rs, Re, and R pi by 1 plus beta, and their conductances are in series. So conductances are added. So this is nothing but, I can always write this as minus V pi by some R equivalent, where R equivalent is given by Rs parallel Re parallel R pi upon 1 plus beta. So this is the parallel combination. So we have the parallel combination of three resistances, RS, RE, and R pi by 1 plus beta. So obviously, I can write the equivalent resistance is nothing but 1 by R equivalent is equal to 1 by RS plus 1 by RE plus 1 by R pi by 1 plus beta. So from this, we can deduce Vs is equal to minus Rs by R equivalent into V pi. So this is the relation between Vs and V pi. And already in the last slide, we have already calculated the expression for V naught, which was like minus Gm V pi times RC. So these are the two equations. This is the expression for Vs. This is the expression for V naught, both in terms of V pi. So if I divide 2 by 1, I'll be getting V naught upon Vs, which is essentially our voltage gain. So this voltage gain is given by, so minus minus, so it will get cancelled. We have Gm times RC in the numerator and divided by, multiplied with R equivalent by RS. So this is nothing but Gm times RC. Now in terms of R equivalent, what we can write? We can write RS parallel RE parallel R pi by 1 plus beta. Divided by RS. So this is the expression for the voltage gain. Now, if I make some approximation that this particular thing, this RS parallel RE parallel R pi by 1 plus beta. Now, you have to identify that there are three resistances connected in shunt path. And you have to identify the typical values of these resistances. Now, RS normally the source resistance, it is in the order of your tens of ohms, like 50 ohms or 40 ohms like this. So RE is the emitter resistance. So obviously it will be in the order of say few kilo ohms. And R pi by 1 plus beta, R pi by 1 plus beta, it is also in the order of few hundreds of ohms. Now out of these three resistances, the equivalent resistance will be governed by the least of these three. And eventually the least value of the resistance is governed by this source resistance RS. So this particular expression for the voltage gain, can be equivalently written as close to, it is Gm times RC. Assuming that this RS, so this equivalent resistance is approximately equal to RS, assuming that the RS is the minimum out of these three. So then this equivalent voltage gain is given by Gm times RC. So a wonderful result we are getting from this expression that there are some information which you can gather from this final expression for this voltage gain. First of all, if I just consider the amplitude of the voltage gain, so it is just like the same which we have obtained during the common emitter amplifier. So for common emitter amplifier, we have found out that the equivalent resistance, the voltage gain of that particular common emitter amplifier was given by Gm times RC. So as far as the magnitude is concerned, the voltage gain of common base amplifier is almost the same, just like a common emitter amplifier. However, for common emitter amplifier, we have seen that there was a negative sign, minus sign outside. So which signifies that there is a phase shift between the input and the output. But in common base amplifier, you see that there is no minus sign outside. So the input signal and output signal, so there is no phase reversal. So if I have an input like this, let me go back over here. So if I have an input like this, so the output will be the magnified version. So for example, if there is a 5 millivolt peak-to-peak signal, if this is 5 millivolt peak-to-peak, and if I assume that there is a voltage gain of 100, then you have over here 500 millivolt. And once again, this positive half cycle will be amplified just like this. So there is no phase reversal. So voltage gain of 100, typically large voltage gain given by GM times RC. However, this voltage gain is dependent upon the transistor internal parameter because it's a function of GM. And at the same time, there is no phase reversal. If I compare this with respect to the voltage gain as obtained with common emitter and common collector amplifier, you'll see that there is some match, some mismatch with respect to common emitter and the common base configuration, common collector configuration. So as far as the common emitter configuration is concerned, the voltage gain is high, just like a common base. The voltage gain is high like GM times RC. It is large. For common collector amplifier, you have seen that the voltage gain is normally less than one. Ideally, I can think that it is close to one, but normally the value is less than one for common collector configuration. So I cannot say that common collector configuration is actually amplifying any signal. But here, just like a common emitter amplifier, this common base amplifier also magnifies the signal by some amount. So the amount is going by GM times RC. So this is the match with respect to common emitter configuration. A similarity, you can say. And on the other hand, if I compare this common collector configuration with the common base configuration, we will also find another similarity in the sense that just like common collector configuration, the common base configuration or common base amplifier doesn't provide any phase difference. For common collector configuration, you have seen that there is no phase difference between the input and the output. Here also for common base configuration, there is no phase difference between the input and output. So common base configuration is having the advantage of both common emitter as well as the common collector configuration. It is having a very high voltage gain, typically given by GM times RC. And on the other hand, there is no phase difference between the input and the output. So these two properties of the common emitter and the common collector configurations are embedded into the common base configuration. Now, after calculating the voltage gain, let us try to find out the current gain. You have already seen that for common emitter configuration, there is a current gain. And this current gain is normally given by the value of the beta. Because for the common emitter configuration, the input current is the base current and the output current is the collector current, and collector current and base current, they are related by IC is equal to beta times IB. So normally it's close to beta for common common emitter configuration. On the other hand, for common collector configuration, you have seen that the input current is the base current and the output current is the emitter current. And therefore, this collector configuration, the corresponding expression for the current gain is almost close to 1 plus it's given by 1 plus beta. Now, similarly, for this common base configuration, we are interested to find out whether there is any gain pertaining to the common base configuration. I mean, current gain, whether there is any current gain or not. So for this, once again, let us draw the circuit, small signal equivalent circuit. So this is the signal source over here. We have RS. And we have RE. The same small signal model, R pi. This is GM times V pi. And then finally, RC. So this is the emitter terminal, this is the collector terminal, this is the base terminal. This is at AC ground. So for current gain AI, I need to find out the output current upon the input current, IO by II. So considering that this is a two-port network, I can always incorporate this one amplifier within a black box like this. The two-port network, so I can always consider into a two-port network, which is incorporated into the black box. So how to find out the current gain? Suppose this current is given by the input current and this current is the output current. So there are some formulations for the input current and the output current. For two-port network, as you know, as far as our convention is concerned, let there be two ports like this, port 1 and port 2. So suppose here this is V1, potential at port 1, potential at port 2, let it be V2, and the current that is entering is say I1, and for port 2 it is I2. So as far as the convention is concerned, the current entering the network is considered to be the positive direction of the current. Similarly, for the output terminal, for the second terminal, the current entering is considered to be the positive direction of the current. And while measuring the voltage, so already we have established this configuration that this terminal is considered to be at a higher potential with respect to this terminal. Similarly, this terminal is considered to be at a higher potential with respect to this terminal. So therefore, I'm assuming that this is the current direction for the input. That means this is II. This direction is considered to be the positive direction, and this direction is considered to be the positive direction for the output current. So IO by II, this is the expression for current gain, AI. So you can easily observe that this IO output current is exactly same, just like GM times VPi, same direction. So IO is equal to GM times VPi, that is fine. Now, in order to find out II, once again, you have to apply Kirchhoff's current law at the emitter terminal. So at the emitter terminal, once again, as you know, so with respect to base, so this potential is at a higher, so this is VPi, this potential is VPi. So VPi is nothing but the voltage difference between this base and the emitter. So therefore, the current will move from this terminal to this terminal, from base to emitter. So if I apply KCL at node E, we will find that all the currents they are entering this terminal E. So there are four components of current. GM VPi is one component. VPi by RPi is the second component. VPi by RA is the third component. And the fourth component is II. So I can write II plus VPi by RE plus VPi by RPi plus GM VPi is equal to zero. So from which I can write II is equal to minus VPi by RE minus GM VPi plus VPi by RPi. So this is equal to minus VPi by RE minus. So now once again, this same expression GM plus 1 by RPi. So that could have been written like VPi into 1 plus beta upon RPi. So if I take minus VPi outside, so this is nothing but 1 by RE plus 1 plus beta by RPi. So I can always visualize this is nothing but minus VPi upon some R equivalent, where R equivalent is given by RE parallel RPi by 1 plus beta. So this is the expression for the input current II given by this. So if I would like to find out the corresponding current gain, so the current gain is obtained like this. We have GM times VPi. GM times VPi over here. IO upon minus VPi by R equivalent. So this is coming like minus Gm times R equivalent. So if I just consider the magnitude of this current gain, mod of this AI, so mod of this AI is given by Gm times R equivalent. Now if I just observe the expression for this R equivalent, once again, this is nothing but the shunt connection, parallel connection of two resistances. One is RE, second one is R pi upon 1 plus beta. Now, as you know, if there are two resistances connected in shunt, then the equivalent resistance is governed by the lower out of these two. Now, RE, which is the emitter resistance, is in the order of few kilo ohms, whereas R pi is in the order of few hundreds of ohms. So, therefore, this R equivalent can be approximated by R pi upon 1 plus beta. So if I just put the value over here, it will be Gm R pi upon 1 plus beta. So what is Gm R pi? Gm R pi, as you know, this is beta. Beta by 1 plus beta. So which is equal to beta by 1 plus beta, which is equal to the alpha. Already you have studied in your basic electronics course that beta is known to be the current gain during the common emitter configuration, and alpha is known to be the current gain during the common base configuration. So here, alpha, as you know, the typical value for alpha is in the order of like few 0.97 to 0.99, within that range. Beta is typically very large, in the order of say 100 to 150 or even larger. If I put beta is equal to say 200 over here, so 200 upon 201. So that ratio is coming close to 0.98 or 0.99. So here, for common base configuration, you have seen that the current gain is typically less than 1. Because for a common base amplifier, the input current is the emitter current and the output current is the collector current. So as you know, that input current, the emitter current is the summation of the base current and the collector current. So therefore, here the current gain is typically less than 1. So this is one of the disadvantages of common base amplifier you can consider. We cannot have any current gain for this common base configuration. While there is a voltage gain whose magnitude is very large, typically like Gm times RC, and there is no phase difference between the input and the output. Now, having calculated the current gain and the voltage gain expression for a common base amplifier, the next step which we need to perform is the analysis of the input and the output impedance, because this is very essential. As long as you are operating the amplifier in a multi-stage configuration, so sometimes it is required to put the amplifier in between two different amplifiers. So to connect the amplifier as an intermediate amplifier, so you have to find out the corresponding input and the output impedance. Now, for your recapitulation, let me tell you that as you know that for common emitter configuration, the corresponding input impedance is governed by R pi, which is in the order of few kilo ohms. Typical value is like 5 kilo ohms for input impedance for a common emitter amplifier. And the output impedance is basically governed by RC, which is the collector resistance. And RC value is normally in the range of a few kilo ohms. So therefore, for common emitter configuration, both the input resistance and the output resistance, they are moderate. They are moderate, because the value is in the order of few kilo ohms. Now, coming back to the common collector configuration, perhaps you can recall, last year we also calculated the expression for the input impedance and the output impedance. So for common collector configuration, the input impedance was large because of this resistance reflection rule. If you can remember, the expression was like R pi plus 1 plus beta times RE. So because of this magnification by 1 plus beta, the input impedance was typically large and in the order of few hundreds of kilo ohms for common collector amplifier. However, for the common collector amplifier, the output impedance is pretty small, and the output impedance was given like a few tens of ohms or hundreds of ohms. So for common collector configuration, the input impedance is large and the output impedance is very small. And that's why this common collector configuration is typically used as a voltage buffer. We don't have any voltage gain over here. The typical voltage gain is less than 1 or close to 1, but the input impedance is very large and the output impedance is very small, which is the desirable characteristics to connect it to any voltage amplifier. So normally this common collector amplifier is used as the last stage of any multi-stage amplifier. Now let us see what happens with the common base configuration. So for common base configuration, we need to calculate the corresponding expression for the input and the output impedance. So for input impedance, already we know this is the circuit. We have R pi over here, and we have GM times V pi over here. There is R pi, there is GM times V pi. This is the emitter terminal, this is the collector terminal over here, and base terminal is typically at ground. So this is the base terminal, which is typically at ground potential, and while finding out this expression for, so this is GM times V pi, this is GM times V pi over here, and what was V pi? This is the V pi. So what we can do is we can also change the notation of V pi. And that means instead of representing V pi as the difference between base to emitter, we can also write V pi as the difference between emitter to base, so that our conventional direction is maintained. So as you know, for conventional direction, this terminal is considered with a positive with respect to this terminal. So this is equivalent to this. This particular circuit is equivalent to this circuit. If I just replace V pi with some, if I replace V pi with some minus V pi dashed or like this, so then this voltage will be V pi dashed. This is the emitter terminal. This is a base terminal. So here the current direction will be reversed. So it will be like this: GM times V pi dashed, just like this. Now you are connecting the input over here. You are connecting the input signal over here between these two terminals. So once again, you know, to find out the input resistance. So what is the resistance failed by? What is the resistance failed by the signal source? So this is the, this is inside the amplifier. This is inside the amplifier. Now you are, you have connected the signal source over here with some source resistance like this. Now what is the resistance failed by the signal source? So how to identify the resistance? So you have to find out what is the voltage drop across these two points, and what is the current being drawn? What is the current being drawn by the amplifier? So the effective input resistance is given by this V pi dashed divided by II. So for any amplifier, suppose I have a black box like this, I don't know what is there inside, and I have connected one, I have one signal source like this, and I would like to find out the input impedance provided by this black box. So how to find out the input impedance? I just connect this to the input terminal of this black box and just measure what is the voltage available over here. And regarding the calculation of the voltage, we have made this assumption that this terminal is positive with respect to this terminal. And what is the current being drawn by this amplifier or by this black box? Suppose this current being drawn is given by I in. So this is suppose V in, this is suppose I in. So R in, the input impedance or input resistance, is given by V in upon I in. So here we have the same expression, V pi dashed upon II, or I can also write like V in by I in, same thing, where V in is given by minus V pi. Okay. So if I have I or I in over here, so this current is entering this emitter terminal. This current is entering the emitter terminal, I in. And there are two components of current which are leaving the terminal. One is this GM V pi dashed or GM V in, and the second one is this V pi dashed by R pi. So applying this common, I mean, at this particular point at the emitter terminal, if I apply KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, then I will find that I in, the current that is entering, is equal to the current that is leaving. So what is that current? That current is given by V in upon R pi plus GM times V in. So these are the two currents which are leaving the emitter terminal, and the current that is entering is I in. So if I take V in outside, then it will be GM plus 1 by R pi. So the expression we have already calculated, 1 plus beta upon R pi. So from this, we can find out the input resistance given by Vin upon Iin. For the common base configuration, it is coming like R pi upon 1 plus beta. So now you look at the expression for the input resistance. So for common emitter configuration, you have seen that the input resistance is very is moderate, in the order of few kilo ohms, typically governed by this R pi. And here the input impedance is given by R pi upon 1 plus beta. Whereas for common collector configuration, the input impedance was governed by R pi plus 1 plus beta times RD. So there is a order difference between the input impedance. So for common emitter configuration, it is moderate. For common collector configuration, it is high. And for common base configuration, it is very small. So this is the expression for the input impedance. Now you can also, I have actually left one part. You can also connect one RD over here, because if I just consider the small signal equivalent circuit over here, you'll see that we have an RD over here, RD connected in shunt with R pi. Now that is fine. So what you can do in order to find out the effective impedance, what you can do is, already you have this R pi upon 1 plus beta. Already you have got this one, R pi upon 1 plus beta. Now if you have an additional resistance RD in shunt with that, so the effective resistance will be nothing but R pi upon 1 plus beta parallel RD. Just like this, R pi upon 1 plus beta parallel RD. But once again, since the value of this R pi upon 1 plus beta is smaller as compared to RD, so equivalent resistance will be governed by R pi upon 1 plus beta. So this is the equivalent resistance. Equivalent input resistance is governed by R pi upon 1 plus beta. You can also connect one RD in shunt with that, as was there in the small signal model. But since this resistance is large with respect to this R pi upon 1 plus beta, so the equivalent resistance will finally be governed by this R pi upon 1 plus beta, which is typically very small as compared to the resistance for common emitter and common collector configuration. Now we need to find out the output resistance. So for calculating the output resistance, as you know, the input signal must be absent. So we have RD, we have R pi, and we have GM times V pi. MRC. V pi means, this is the notation V pi. So GM times V pi. If I write V pi as this terminal positive with respect to this terminal, so in that case, the direction of the current will be reversed. So here I am assuming that V pi is nothing but the voltage drop between the base and the emitter. So that's why the direction is from this end to that end. So I can have RS over here, but this is absent. Signal source is absent. I can connect RS. This is RC. Now to find out the output impedance, an externally connected voltage source, Vx, is over here, and the corresponding current being drawn by the circuit is Ix. So in order to find out the common, I mean, the output impedance for this common base configuration, so what is done, the input signal, the input small signal is absent. Last day I've also explained how to calculate this H22. This is nothing but 1 upon I2 by V2. And how to calculate this I2 by V2? Making V1 equal to 0. So making the input signal absent. So we have to find out, we have to connect one externally external signal, voltage signal over here, Vx. And what is the current being drawn by this, amplifier circuit? Suppose this is Ix. So this particular signal source, it will provide an amplitude of Vx, and the current being drawn by the circuit is given by Ix. So as far as the output impedance is concerned, this output resistance is obtained by this Vx upon Ix. So once again, I can apply a KCL at this particular node, at emitter node. So we have four components of current. So since this potential is V pi with respect, so this is at ground, this is a ground potential. So I'm assuming that this terminal is at a higher potential with respect to this terminal. So all the currents will flow in this direction. So all the four components of current are entering the emitter terminal. So I can write the expression Gm times V pi plus V pi upon R pi plus V pi upon Re plus V pi upon Rs is equal to zero. So from this, I can deduce that V pi is equal to zero. Now, since V pi is equal to zero, due to the calculation of the output resistance, so this terminal, these two terminals are basically short circuited because V pi, the voltage drop equal to zero. So essentially, these are short circuited during the calculation of the output impedance. Now, since it is short, so the effective output resistance is governed by the collector resistance RC. So here, the output resistance R naught is typically governed by RC, the collector resistance for common base configuration. Now, already in this particular calculation, we have neglected R naught, this output resistance, which is connected between the collector to the emitter terminal. Now, if I want to introduce this R naught in our analysis, so in that case, the output resistance will be typically infinite. So for common base configuration, you have seen that this input resistance is very small, in the order of few tens of ohms, like 20 ohms or 40 ohms. And the output resistance is typically moderate to high, either RC or you can also incorporate if there is R naught. So even if there is an R naught, so this is typically infinite, very large value, hundreds of kilo ohms with respect to RC, where RC is in the order of few tens of kilo ohms, the output resistance. So if I have a parallel combination, so once again, the output resistance is governed by the lower out of these two. So the output resistance here, it is moderate for common base configuration. Now, let us try to summarize what we have already discussed in our discussion for the last few days. Let us considering the different attributes. One is the voltage gain. Second one is the current gain. So these are the different attributes of any amplifier. Then we have the input resistance. Input resistance. And finally, output resistance. Now, with respect to these parameters, let us try to classify the different configuration. We have started with common emitter configuration. Then you have a common base configuration, or let it be common collector, because we have discussed common collector first. So let it be common collector then. Common collector and then common base. So for common emitter amplifier, the voltage gain AV is typically much, much higher than one. As you've already seen, the typical value was like Gm times RC. So much, much higher than one, the voltage gain for the common emitter configuration. The current gain AI is also very large because it is essentially governed by beta, which is the current gain of the BJT itself. So AI is also very, very greater than one. Input impedance, I can say it is moderate. Impedance is moderate, given by R pi. So as the output resistance is also moderate. Now coming back to the common collector configuration, we have seen that voltage gain for common collector configuration is essentially equal to one. So there is no such voltage gain. Whatever the input you're applying at the base terminal, at the emitter terminal, you are supposed to get the same input with no phase difference. So almost the same signal. So there is no phase difference, there is no voltage gain. So that's why it is used as a voltage buffer. It's common collector configuration. The voltage gain is typically one but practically the value should be less than 1, as we have already discussed in the last day. And for the common collector configuration, the current gain is much, much greater than 1, because here the input current is the base current and output current is emitter current, which are related by IE is equal to 1 plus beta times IB. And if I incorporate this into the amplifier structure, we'll also see that this current gain is much, much higher. And it's close to, under some ideal condition, it is close to 1 plus beta. So that's why current gain is also very, very greater than 1. And the input impedance is very high. Input impedance is very high for common collector configuration, given by this R pi plus 1 plus beta times RD, which is known as a resistance reflection rule. So input impedance is very large, which is a very desirable parameter for any voltage amplifier. And the output impedance is also very low. This is another desirable parameter. So as far as the input impedance and the output impedance is concerned, so common collector is having the most desirable property. Now coming back to the common base, here you see that the voltage gain is typically much, much greater than 1. But the current gain value, AI, if I consider, this is almost close to 1. Even it is less than 1. Given by alpha, as we have seen, typically it is, even if I consider RS equal to 0, that means your source resistance is very small. So in that case, it is approaching towards alpha, and where alpha is less than 1, like 0.98 or 0.99. So current gain cannot exceed 1. So max to max, it will be 1 for common base, because input current is the emitter current and output current is the collector current. So obviously the current gain is less than 1, but ideally, it is pretty much close to 1. Now, as far as the input impedance is concerned, input resistance is low, which is not a good attribute as a voltage amplifier for the common base. And the output impedance, we can say moderate or moderate to high. So output impedance is moderate or moderate to high. Now, while designing an amplifier, suppose I am having a black box like this. I would like to have an amplifier. I would like to purchase an amplifier from the market. So while purchasing any amplifier from the market, so this is an amplifier, for example, 2 input port, 2 output port, just like this. Now these are the parameters, AV, AI, R in, R out, and another thing which we have not discussed yet, that is the bandwidth, that is V. So these are the essential properties of any amplifier: voltage gain, current gain, input impedance, output impedance, and the bandwidth. So as far as the requirement is concerned, we always expect that the voltage gain should be as high as possible, current gain should be as high as possible. For voltage amplifier, the input impedance should be as high as possible, and the output impedance should be as low as possible, and the bandwidth should be as high as possible. So these are the essential requirements from the voltage amplifier's perspective. But if I consider these three models or three different configurations, common emitter configuration, common collector configuration, and common base configuration, you will see that none out of these three provides all these essential characteristics simultaneously. For example, if I consider common base, so voltage gain is greater than 1, very, very greater than 1, but the current gain is not very high, it is 1. And the input impedance is low, output impedance is moderate, which is not at all the desirable parameter. For common collector, all the parameters are fine except voltage gain. So voltage gain is close to 1. So this is not the desirable property for the common collector. However, if I consider common emitter, you'll see that, I mean, all the 4 parameters, they are almost in the, as far as our requirement is concerned. So they are in line with our requirements. Voltage gain is very, very greater than 1. It's large, typically large. Current gain is also large. And the input and output resistance is moderate. So none of the input or output resistance is high or low, so moderate. So that's why, all the properties out of these 4, input resistance, output resistance, voltage gain, and current gain, out of these 4 properties, since common emitter configuration satisfies all the 4 properties or 4 parameters, so in that case, we can consider that for most of the applications, this common emitter configuration is typically used, because this provides a suitable value for voltage gain, current gain, input and output resistance. However, if I just compare this common emitter with the common base, you must wonder that a common base doesn't provide anything, because the voltage gain is high, fine, but the input resistance is low. So if the input resistance is very low, so in that case, we cannot use this common base configuration as a voltage amplifier. But you know that whenever we have a current amplifier kind of thing, so in which case the input signal is a current source instead of a voltage source, so in that case our requirement should be the input resistance of the amplifier should be as small as possible, because we have a current source kind of thing. If I just consider the Norton equivalent circuit, if I have a Norton equivalent circuit, so in which case, suppose I'm having a current source like this, IS. And we have an RS like this. So this is connected to some amplifier, which is the current amplifier over here. Now this amplifier is having some source resistance. Now if this source resistance is small with respect to this particular resistance RS, so obviously you expect that most of the signal current will flow through this. So for common base configuration, we can typically use it as a current amplifier. But here also there is one problem associated with this, because the corresponding current gain is typically very small. I mean, it is less than one or close to one. So, but it is normally used, this common base configuration is normally used as a current buffer because of this property, low input impedance and moderate output impedance. So looking at these three configurations, you must wonder that common base configuration essentially doesn't provide any advantage out of these three. So what is the utility of common base configuration? So let me tell you in a short that so far we have discussed only these four properties, this voltage gain, this current gain, this input resistance, and this output resistance. So obviously we want that voltage gain should be high, current gain should be high, and for voltage amplifier, input resistance should be large and the output resistance should be small. And so common emitter configuration satisfies all these properties reasonably good. So I can select common emitter configuration for our operation. But so far we have neglected this bandwidth parameter. So this is another important parameter. So what do you mean by bandwidth? So whenever we have an amplifier like this, suppose we have a signal source like this, small signal source, having a frequency of f. So suppose this particular amplifier provides a corresponding gain for a particular FO, a particular frequency FO. Now, if you increase the value of F naught, then you'll see that the corresponding gain parameter will drop down. Essentially, for any amplifier, let me tell you very briefly, for any amplifier, the expression of the voltage gain, or it looks something like that. We will discuss this one in detail. Is a typical frequency response. So this is the gain. This is the gain of the amplifier. And this is the frequency. And this is known to be the bandwidth of the amplifier, over which the gain is remaining essentially constant. So this is the bandwidth B. So we must want that the value of B should be as high as possible. Suppose this is F1 and this is F2. So I can magnify any input signal between this range, F1 to F2. So obviously, our requirement should be the enhancement of the gain. That is the one requirement from our side. And the second requirement is the enhancement of the bandwidth. But unfortunately, the gain bandwidth product is constant. We will discuss this in detail. So if you make any attempt to increase the gain, you'll see that the bandwidth is reduced. And on the other hand, if you make any attempt to increase the bandwidth, you'll see that the gain parameter is reduced to some extent. But however, our requirement is to enhance the gain as well as the enhancement of this bandwidth parameter, so that over a wide range of frequency we can amplify the signal. Because here within this mid band range, you will find that the gain is typically constant. There is no change in the gain, it is flat. Now this is the advantage provided by the common base amplifier. We will discuss this in detail while considering the frequency model, or while considering the effect of different capacitors. So there you will see that the common base configuration provides a sufficient value of higher bandwidth as compared to the common emitter to common collector configuration. So once again, as of now, you must wonder that common base configuration is having no such advantage, because this input impedance low, output impedance is moderate, current gain, we don't have a sufficient value of current gain. But you can understand, or you can appreciate the importance of common base configuration while we will be discussing the role of different capacitors in controlling the bandwidth of an amplifier. So in a short, I can tell you that there are typically, we can divide it into two different segments, two different types of capacitors. One are the externally connected capacitors, which we've already seen. One is the coupling capacitor. The second one is the bypass capacitor. So these capacitors are there externally connected in the circuit, the bypass capacitor and coupling capacitor. And apart from that, there are several transistor internal capacitor, because you know transistor is a three-terminal device. So there are two PN junctions between, one is between emitter to base, second one is between base to collector. So obviously there will be different parasitic effects provided by the transistor itself. And these capacitors are also playing pivotal role in controlling the bandwidth of any amplifier. So this external capacitor and the internal capacitor, both of them are playing very important role in controlling the bandwidth parameter of any amplifier. And while discussing that particular module, you'll see that this common base configuration is providing the biggest advantage over common emitter and the common collector amplifier. Now with this, we are at the end of this small signal amplifier involving three different modes or configuration, common emitter, common base, and common collector. More specifically, we have only considered the single stage amplifier, small signal single stage amplifier, but we need to discuss about the multi-stage amplifier. But before discussing the multi-stage amplifier, I believe it will be better to discuss about the role of the capacitors in controlling the bandwidth of an amplifier. So with this, let me stop today's discussion.